Hi, I'm Ashiq Rahman from Accounting Celebrity. Welcome to my channel, where I upload several accounting tutorials weekly. Today in this lesson, I'm going to show you how to prepare a rent receivable account. Let's get started. Okay, so here this is the format for this account. Here we have six columns, date, detail, dollar. If you want to draw a folio column here and here, you can draw, no problem. Okay. So today I'll show you this question, which is taken from Cambridge IGCSE accounting first paper. So let us have a look at the question on the screen. Aisha Treat's children shows, okay, her financial year ends on 31st January. Okay, so here in the question, the financial year ends on 31st January. Okay, let us write here 2019. Okay, so if it is the ending of the year, so what is the beginning of the year? So this will be very simple, 1st February 2018. Yeah, so now check, it is 12 months from 1st February 2018 to 31st January. It is 12 months, so this is the financial period for Aisha. Okay, let us have a look at the question once again. Aisha rents a warehouse at an annual rent of $6,000. She sublets the part of the premises to a tenant. Okay, so then what is written? The following information is available. That means here we have some transactions. Okay, now what is your requirement? Prepare the rent payable account and the rent receivable account in the ledger of Aisha for the year ended 31st January 2019. Balance the account and bring down the balances on 1st February 2019. Okay, so rent payable account is already done. So I'm going to recommend you to watch that video because this will help you to understand this account as well. Okay, so link is here in the I button. You can watch it, then come back to this lesson. Okay, so now we will do here rent receivable account. Yeah, so let us write here rent receivable account. Okay, now have a look at the question on the screen. 2018 February 1, Aisha had paid 2 months rent in advance. Okay, this will not come, this will go to the rent payable account. Already we have taken there. Okay, then what is written? The tenant owes $600 rent. Okay, this will come. So owes means outstanding, the tenant, the one who is using this warehouse. Okay, so this is the money is not paid, owes. Okay, if we see that there is an opening balance which is not paid, okay, unpaid, it will be treated as balance PD. Okay, will be recorded on the debit side. Okay, if there is any advance, this will be also balance PD, but this will be recorded on the credit side. Okay, so this unpaid amount means the amount which is not paid. Okay, here is written that the tenant owes $600. Okay, so this is unpaid amount, so this is balance PD and it will be recorded on the debit side. But if there is an advance for the same question, for the same account, then will be recorded as a balance PD on the credit side. Okay, don't be confused, will be the 1st February 2018 first. Okay, so we will write here balance BD, the amount is on the question, $600. Okay, very simple. So what is our next transaction? March 31st, cash received for rent $800. Yes, cash received from the tenant. Yeah, it will be recorded here. Yeah, we are doing rent receivable account, so we received cash. So what is the double entry here? What is the transition journal? So cash received, so cash will be here debited. Yeah, and what is credited? Rent receivable account to be credited. Yeah, so rent receivable to be credited. Now what account we are doing? We are doing here rent receivable account. Yeah, so rent receivable account is here credit. Okay, so we will record on the credit side. So let us write here 2018 March 31st. Okay, we will write here cash, and how much we received? It is $800. Okay, very good. What is your next transition? April 30, Aisha paid 6 months rent by bank transfer. Okay, this will not come, this will go to the rent payable account. Forget it. Next one is May 1st, check received for rent $2,000. Yes, this will come. Okay, check receipt. So I shall receive the check from the tenant. Okay. So what is the double entry for Aisha? What is the transaction Aisha will make for her accounts? So Aisha will write here bank first. Why bank? Because Aisha received this $2,000 by check. Yeah. So bank is to be here debited. Yeah. Same thing Aisha received for rent purpose. Yeah. So it is an income for Aisha. Income is here credit. So let us write here rent receivable account. It is here credited. Okay. Which account we are doing? We are doing rent receivable account. Yeah. So it is here credited. Yeah. So we have to go to the credit side. Okay. And we will write here the opposite account, which is bank. So let us write here date first 2018 May 1st. We will write here bank and the amount is here $2,000. Finished, over. Okay, what do you have next? October 31st, Aisha paid 7 months rent. Okay, Aisha paid, that is, it is an expense. That means it will go to the rent payable account. So we will not think about this transaction, okay. Then what is next? 2019, January 31st, transfer to the income statement from the rent receivable account, $2,400. Okay, so Aisha now transfer $2,400 to the income statement. Okay, so how to record this transition? So many of you have huge confusion when you transfer any amount from rent receivable account to the income statement or rent payable account to the income statement. Okay, but remember the entry. Okay, adjustment entry. Okay, so what to do here? So how to transfer? So here Aisha will write rent receivable account to be debited and income statement to be here credited. Okay, so look at here, rent receivable account to be debited. Yeah, so we have to come on the debit side. We have to write on the debit side, but what to write? We have to write income statement, the opposite account. Okay, so let us write here 2019 January 31st income statement. Yeah, okay. So the amount is here $2,400. So we completed recording relevant transactions. Okay, now what to do? We are required to balance this account. So how to balance it? What to do it now? So first of all, we have to compare these two dollar columns, okay, this and this. We have to check which column is greater in terms of money, yeah? So if we check this and these two columns, we find this debit side, debit dollar column is greater, yeah? So here, if we add these two amount, we get $3,000, okay? So let us add this amount and write here $3,000, okay? Now what to do? We will take this amount to the opposite side, okay? Let us go there and write the same amount, $3,000, okay? Now what to do? We have to subtract this and this amount from this total, okay? So here, if we subtract, we get $200, yeah? So now, what is this amount? What does this amount cover? This is the closing balance of this rent receivable account. You already know it. So we will write here balance carried down. Yeah, CD. Okay, means balance carried down. Okay, now the date for balance CD. What date? Date is the last day of the accounting period or financial period. So her financial year ends on 31st January. Okay. So let us write here 2019 January 31st. Okay. So now let us have a look at the question. Okay. So what was our requirement? Prepare the rent payable account and the rent receivable account in the ledger of Aisha for the year ended 31st January 2019. Balance the accounts and bring down the balances on 1st February 2019. Okay. So we completed everything. Just now we have to bring down, okay? So let us bring down here balance PD. So what is this? $200, okay? Now the date per balance PD, okay, is given in the question. It is 2019 February 1st, okay? Even if the date is not given in the question, we have to write it, okay? So how to understand which date will be written? So for balance PD, the date will be the first day of next financial period, okay? So here Aisha's financial year was 1st February 2018 to 31st January 2019, okay? So what is her next financial period? So it will be 1st February 2019 to 31st January 2020, yeah? So we write here February 1st, okay? And always remember, the balance sheet date will be the last day of the financial period. Here it is 31st January. We wrote here 31st January, okay? So this is all about your today's lesson. I hope you understood and enjoyed this lesson. If you think that this video is helpful for you, please share with your friends. And please consider subscribing to our channel, because there are other so many accounting video tutorials. Those will help you to understand accounting, to learn accounting, to prepare yourself for accounting exam or test. So this is all. I'll see you soon with new video. Until then, bye bye and take care.